Dane Faitelson and Saul Baird explore the joy of married life in the wedding toast.
Darling Dirk, our only son, your married life has just begun. We are grateful to have lived to see this day. We compiled some sage advice to get you past the cake and rice. Take it from your mom and dad. There's quite a lot to say.
If you want to keep the moxie in your mate, you must dress each night as if you're on a date. The meals you create should rival Le Cirque. That is how to make a marriage work.
It is, it's very true. If you want to keep the union in the pink, never leave the dirty dishes in the sink. The garbage may stink, but you mustn't shirk. That is how to make a marriage work, right?
Home and hearth, bed and bath, cultivate that primrose bath. Every room, love in bloom. If you remember these lessons, if you want to live in joyful wedded bliss, and your nightly fight with one big kiss,
surrender the smirk.
That is how to make a marriage work.
Darling.
Darling.
If you want to have a healthy habitat, you must never tell her that she's gotten fat. It causes a spat, it rends you a jerk. That's not how to make a marriage work.
If your husband's insecure about his size,
oh boy,
don't let on, I'll think you've won the booby prize. It's highly unwise to curse little Kirk. That's not how to make a marriage work.
Pound for pound,
inch by inch, married life can be a cinch.
Separate lives, men and wives, battling boredom together.
So he tells you that their bedroom's lacking zinc.
Woo!
Then he shows you every website where they swing. He loses his wig, the lover may look. That is not how to make a marriage work.
Out when shopping at the store.
If he gets about parading with his heart.
If you don't ignore those habits that hurt, that is how to make a marriage work. Side by side,
year to year, dead desire,
rough career,
tighten the yoke.
What a joke!
Welcome to conjugal prison.
So you fell in love, see that's your first mistake.
I wonder how much alimony it'll take.